So if you are to take a look at why all this happens, it's because PCOS does not occur due to a single cause. It is a multifactorial condition, meaning different factors in your environment and in your body together act and contribute to forming PCOS. So the first important thing is genetics, and this needs to be said out loud. You did not do anything to cause your PCOS. There is a big genetic factor involved. 20-40% of females have first-degree relatives with PCOS, meaning if you have a relative with PCOS, the odds are 2 out of 5 chances you are going to have it too. And by first-degree relatives, I mean mothers or sisters with PCOS. The second thing is insulin resistance. So in insulin resistance, your body is not responsive to insulin, whose main role is to make sure that the glucose in your body, that when you eat, when there's increased glucose in your bloodstream, the role of insulin is to pick up this blood glucose and to put it inside the various cells of your body. And when your body is not responsive to this insulin, it keeps thinking that there is still enough glucose and it needs to be cleared. And as a result, it's like a positive feedback cycle and your insulin keeps on increasing. So because of insulin resistance, what really happens is there is an increased androgen production in the body or an androgen excess. And that too much testosterone, it's responsible for your clinical symptoms that you see, such as acne, such as excessive hair growth, also called as hirsutism. Then it's also responsible for mood changes and depression and male pattern hair loss. And this excess androgen also prevents ovulation, which is the biggest manifestation that it has. So it prevents development of follicles. So once you don't have ovulation, then you have difficulty having a baby, irregular periods, and in general, you have that appearance of polycystic ovaries on your ovary.